Oh, it's really Cobra. I'm not gonna porn bomb you. What up? Yeah, yeah.
Crystal, you're so out of the team, man.
That was so gross.
Bogdan, how surprised are you to see him on here right now?
I see Josh all the time. I wanted to just come say hi, though.
Warlord, I heard that he has a new ailment. Is that right? He's sick.
Uh-oh. No, well, he told me he had cancer, and then I was told that that was bullshit. So,
why would he do that?
For attention, because he's lying.
Just oh, you can see through it, though, huh?
Yeah.
It doesn't feel good to be lied to like that. Are you kind of mad at him?
A little bit, but just whatever.
I mean, when someone tells you they have cancer and they're lying through their teeth, I think you're in the right to be a little salty about it, yeah.
How did you find out that he was lying?
Because I asked him, what's he going to do about it, like, a week later, and he told me he didn't have it. But after, like, a week before he told me he had it, I'm like, okay, whatever, dude.
It's pretty lame. I mean, he has a history of some fibs. Some white lies.
What would his end goal for that be?
The truth, yes. No offense to Campbell, but that's just how it is.
Yeah. Josh, you got a drink right now?
Yes, I do.
Oh, that's right. You're still sipping on that. My bad.
I just took off Campbell.
How much are those? Do you get those in like
south of the levee.
A six pack or a, just buy like 40s? Or?
$2 a can, and I get them at a single can as at the liquor store.
Nice.
Got any more of those?
Oh, I got like two or three left, yeah.
Awesome, awesome.
I'm so jealous. I wish I could drink.
Bacardi Mango and a bottle of vodka.
Got any G Fuel left?
Oh, I got plenty of G Fuel.
Ooh.
There's G Fuel.
Could we get a new drink combination tonight? Is that in the cards?
I'll see what I can do, yes.
Something, I really like the G Fuel combos. How's that sound?
I could do a G Fuel combo.
You know, call it Rocket Fuel or something. Get you some G Fuel, some kind of booze you got on hand, mix that up, take a big swig. I'll drink something with you if you want. I've got some booze right now because I was terrified to meet you.
Yeah.
Sometimes it can be a little intimidating. You get a little scared. Yeah.
So where did the inspiration for your book come from? Just your love of cobras?
Yes, basically.
I think
what would you do if you finally met the girl who was of age? Let me see if I get this right. She was of age, non-related, cisgendered, of age, and consenting, and alive. And she was beautiful. She had big fucking bouncing bazongas. She was totally got that. What would you do if she was literally your dream come true, but she was terrified of snakes?
And, I didn't know about it.
And she loved mongoose.
Oh.
That's a problem.
I don't know. She would be my dream girl.
But she has, but hold on, because Cobra, that's not one of your forbidden four. Like, liking mongoose is not one of your.
No, it's not. But
so what would you do? How would you handle it? She's perfect. Well, she's not perfect. She's a woman, so she nags, and she, you know, she has period eggs and shit like that. Fucking get in the way, but you know what I mean.
No, I don't know what you mean. I haven't had a girlfriend in almost 5 years, and I'm waiting.
I'm sure you remember. Oh, I have questions about that too.
I'd rather not.
Well, I mean, they're not going to be questions like you. They're not. Hey. So I watched your Walnut song. Someone made a song about your speech on the Walnut.
Yes.
Have you seen that video?
No, I haven't.
Oh, fuck. We should play it because it's super good. Anyway, you're basically, they put it to a, like, some kind of, like, what kind of music would you say that was? See, Jeff?
That, I think, especially what Cobra would understand, it's like a YouTube poop, so to speak. It takes clips and adds music and remixes them,
yeah, but
chopped
this,
and screwed.
Song, it was almost like, oh, fucker, like that song, Let's Get It On, like Marvin Gaye. And it has you talking about the Walnut. Can someone find that video, please, and put it in the chat?
I don't know if he wants to listen to that necessarily. I don't want to speak for him, but...
They turned it into a fucking instructional video guide that's in the form of a song. And it's hilarious. And I have to say, Josh, you're pretty fucking well-versed in the style of... or in the knowledge of Walnuts.
Yeah, yeah.
But I have a question for you, because I agreed with just about everything you said in that about the Walnut, except for the different sizes.
I didn't know they had different sizes. That's intriguing.
Okay, so maybe. Okay, fine. All right, I'll back off this one. I was just wondering, because I just
You're talking to someone who is a little bit frustrated, understandably. He's been having a hard time, and I feel it for you, Cobes.
All I know is that he knows what he's talking about.
He knows what, yeah. I mean,
when it comes
during,
to the Walnut, and now
during his heyday,
what he described,
Cobra was pounding away. You would not believe the number of sexual partners. I'm not even kidding about that. Cobra has had a string of girlfriends.
Like, you know.
Yeah, but
That's
lately he's had some bad luck.
So, because for some reason, and again, you have to forgive me, Josh, I'm brand new to this whole Cobraverse, so I have not, and there's so much lore about you that I have barely scratched the surface. So for some reason, I thought that there was only, like, your first, the Stephanie, and then, like, some girl about that got a cigarette.
No,
that's all
only,
I knew about.
There's only two.
Okay. But weren't you, how long were you with Stephanie?
2 years.
So that was your first, right?
Yes.
So I don't know about for you, but for me, my first, like, that was the relationship that you got to just, like, do, you tried everything with. And I imagine that that's the relationship where you fine-crafted your knowledge about the Walnut.
Yes, it is.
So you owe her a big thanks, right? for donating or for offering up her Walnut for you to explore and master, because you sound like you've mastered it. I mean, I have ex-boyfriends that I'm like, you should watch this video because you didn't know where this was and this guy does.
Yes. Also, my buddy Danny that I went to Job Corps with, he told me a couple tricks too.
What, really? What tricks were those?
The Walnut trick. He told me what it felt like and what to look for.
Oh, so he's the one that came up with the Walnut. You know, when they were talking about Walnuts, I'm like, what the fuck is he fucking comparing the G-spot to a Walnut for? And then I thought about it and I went, oh, okay, that kind of makes sense.
Cobra, my bad. Is this a sore subject? Because we can get away from it.
You're good. I'm just sitting here chilling.
Hell yeah.
Don't
Any chance
chat,
we can get the camera back on? Are you up to no good right now? Little sneaky snake?
Just grabbing a Bud Light, listening.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Well, if you're in the mood, we'd love to see what you're up to. There you are. Welcome back, boyo.
Did you end up going out to dinner with your family?
Mm-hmm.
You broke my heart on that. That was so sad. But I'm glad to hear that you went out to dinner. That's awesome. Where'd you guys go?
Went to Craves.
Oh yeah, Craves.
What is that, like burgers or?
Burgers, all kinds of delicious foods.
Yeah, he did a review a while back talking about that Craves. It's
yeah.
pretty good. Yeah, man. Also, I checked out the Peaches website per your recommendation, Josh.
Fuck yeah.
Cobra.
What's up?
For attracting the women, I'm gonna skip the list. I think we're all in good company here. We're all gonna assume that we're not talking about the not alive, unrelated, so forth. Have you hit up the karaoke bar lately to maybe put out some plain white tees action, attract some women folk?
No, I haven't.
Might help. I mean, we've seen you sing. It's pretty sweet. You know all the songs that get the women, right?
Yeah, I do.
Which ones?
What's his name? All of Me by John Legend.
Well, hopefully we can see you out there sometime soon, Cobra. Man, I remember back in the day you do a live streams from the sandbar. Would you ever do something like that again? Well, shit. I know the trolls might get on your ass about it. As long as you don't say where you're at.
You're there.
What's that? Sorry.
Mark longer there, man.
Oh, yeah. But like another bar. Not the sandbar. They shut down. But
stream at the bar. I just wouldn't say where. You know?
Exactly. Yeah. Just don't say where you're at. And they won't know like where to call and bother them and stuff.
That'd be awesome if you did a live stream from like a karaoke bar. That'd be badass.
You have to be.
Cobra, how much to PayPal you to take some G Fuel?
You're not gonna PayPal me any money for that.
I think we could both use a boost. I'll take a little bit of energy drink or some caffeine, if you will. We can drink it together.
We'll do this together, Cobes. In the fridge.
We could all slam it.
What does G Fuel do? Does it really get you pumped up? Because like I need something that's gonna pump me up for tomorrow. Because
it brings out his demon.
Makes you a demon?
No, it doesn't.
It doesn't? Oh, my bad. I'm sorry, Cobes. I was thinking it gave you that energy. You know, it gives you that power. It channels it.
It does amp you up. Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. When was the last time your demon started to come out, Cobra?
Whenever.
Got some close calls? I'm sorry, one more time?
Whenever I wanted to be honest.
Oh, I got you. I mean, sometimes it slips, though, right? When you get real mad?
Not really, no.
No? Okay. It's fully within control.
The fact that you have the power to control that and you don't abuse it. Same with your powers. Like the fact that when he asked you, like, do you cast spells on people? And you were like, no, I just cast protection spells around myself because I let karma take care of it. That amount of fucking self-control is amazing because with the power that you have, there would be people that would be drunk. I gave my chat a wrench and you should have seen them go fucking just bonkers with drunk off the power.
Can we create a pact to, if you'll get some G Fuel, I'll get some coffee, we'll get a little boost?
Sounds good to me.
Hell yeah, man. I'll be right back. I'm going to make me some coffee.
Sounds good to me.
All right. If I had G Fuel, I'd be drinking that shit.
I'll be right back with you.
I'd play something, but I don't have it. Can you play that fart song or that fart music? See, Jeff? I'm just putting this fucking shitty ass brain that's not dark at all.
G Fuel, baby.
Mm-hmm.
Show that logo.
Not a sponsor.
Not a sponsor.
The logo from Ken Domic.
For what?
From Ken Domic, KBG Productions TV, does food reviews in Canada.
Oh, yeah. I mean, they give that stuff away to those channels. That's like a big old sponsorship. Phase X. What are we mixing it into?
Here's the G Fuel with some water. We're going to mix it with some mango Bacardi.
Ooh.
Oh, my God.
Now, I can't remember. Is this a new combination?
Yes, you want a new... the shit is so potent. You want a new combo.
King Cobra definitely delivers. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
You really care about your fans.
I do. Cheers to that. That's enough.
Yeah, man. I have some black coffee with ice in it. Nothing more goth than that, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
You black is my black. Soul.
Yes.
You don't put anything in it?
No.
Gross.
Yeah, it's pretty gross. I just want to get it in me.
Ew.
Yeah, you're definitely just drinking it for the effect then at that point, huh?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. No one said it was going to be easy. Oh, look at that. It's cloudy, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So that's, what is it? What is it, your G Fuel and what?
G Fuel Bud Light and Mango Bacardi.
Mango Bacardi. Mixing a beer with the hard alcohol. You've got some balls on you. Because.
Oh, yeah. Check that
if
out.
If I was to mix. Brew, if I was to mix beer with hard liquor, I would be fucking. I'd be on the floor and probably not clothed.
A little more beer to the mix. Oh, it changed color then.
Now yeah, it's.
Oh, whenever you're done, I'll be curious to know what that tastes like.
Mm.
Yeah. Well done.
Like Skittles, mangoes, and beer.
Not bad at all.
That doesn't. That's crazy.
Yeah. No,
Josh,
he knows how to mix
done
some drinks.
A drink combo, taking a drink of it, and been like, okay, yeah, no, that's a fucking no.
I'm going to blow my nose. Mm.
Someone called it Cobra's Fog. That's a pretty good name. Yeah.
Cobra's Fog. We just named it.
Yeah, well, it's canon, you guys. We did it.
Cobra's Fog!
Dude, that's Screech.
I'm like the only Cradle of Filth fan who can shriek like Danny Phil.
You're the last one, my friend. Josh, I was learning a little bit about autism, and there's a proper name for being able to recreate people's voices. Did you know that?
No, I did not know that.
They call it echolalia, and it's one of, I would say, your abilities that you have, being able to hear something.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
I've heard you do Ozzy.
You can quote movies.
I'm the Prince of fucking Darkness.
Sharon!
Oh, shit. Who let Ozzy in here?
That Sharon is fucking spot on.
Yeah.
And then I've heard you do SpongeBob.
Bye! Patrick, Barnacle, Jimmy, fishing out. Barnacle, what the fucking ghost? Barnacle,
fucking ghost. I love a SpongeBob that cusses.
You almost got me that time, Cobra. I almost spit my coffee out. That caught me off guard, my
dude.
Can
you do any of the other characters?
Yes. Goddamn motherfucking trolls. You suck my dick. Arrgh, Plankton, you don't have a dick. Fuck you, Krabs. Your daughter's a whale of a cunt.
Aw, yeah. Cobra, that's amazing.
You could do a whole episode just by yourself.
Yeah.
That'd be epic.
Oh, there's Squidward.
Barely, I can do a shitty Squidward. I don't know.
Cobra, the actual voice actor for SpongeBob, he would have to kind of karate chop himself in his neck while he'd do the laugh, but I don't think you have to do that at all. You can just do it. Yeah, man, you don't have to, like, chop yourself in the neck while you're doing that from what I've seen. The actual guy had to do it.
You're a big fan of South Park, right?
Goddamn it, I'm a fan of South Park.
There it is. That's what I was going for.
Holy shit, dude. Oh my god, they killed Kenny. Oh my gosh.
I'd say, because with those as well, they like speed it up or pitch shift it or something. So I figure if you did that to Cobra's voice, you'd have a one-to-one, like spot-on recreation.
But he doesn't
like
even need
Cartman
that to be
then.
Done to his voice, and he still sounds like
he's
that.
Already there, pretty much.
Yeah. You could do a whole episode of fucking South Park, too.
Sounds about okay.
Yeah. Oh, Mr. Mackey. Yeah. Killing it, Cobra.
Do you practice these things, or do you just hear a voice one time and then you can do it?
Oh, I practice them a bit, yeah.
And you can't do it like with any voice. It just has to be like a voice that resonates with you.
I can do a Mickey Mouse. Uh-huh. What the fuck is this bullshit? Fucking Mickey Mouse. Holy crap,
shit, y'all. Cobra.
Mickey Mouse. Oh, who the fuck are you? I'm Family Guy. Pretty Griffin. How you doing?
Man. No,
Josh,
it's
do you draw by any chance?
I haven't drawn in a hot minute, but yes, I draw.
Nice.
I could picture that. I could see you being someone who draws.
Well, he did his mansion at one point. He did a little schematic for us a while back.
Yeah, I did the drawings of my dream house. It was amazing.
Yeah.
Do you understand, like, blueprints and stuff? Like, could you do that?
Like, I kind of get, here's my Piccolo voice. I kind of get the drawing, yes. The blueprint.
Nice. Yeah, man. Cartoon Network, hire this man.
No shit. What? He should be doing that. No, he should make up his own cartoon about, you know, and then do his own.
He's willing to sign me, and when things start rolling, you're going to see a Cobra with his own cartoon.
Would you already have ideas in mind? Like,
yeah, I already got ideas in mind.
Would it be a cartoon, like an adult cartoon, like, you know, Del Park is, or would you do a child?
Oh, yes. It would be an adult cartoon. And one of the characters would be a pot-smoking banana slug, and that's all I'm going to say on that. One of out of the three main characters.
Wait. Have you already figured out the voice for that?
Banana slug?
Oh, yeah! Bee slug in the house!
Woo! You know what that kind of sounds like? That kind of sounds like Mr. Hanky.
You can also recall movies really well. You've done Fox and the Hound, Tombstone. You get it word for word. Even the timing is spot on. It's crazy.
Your favorite fox was after my chickens. Rubbish and polycot. I don't believe it. You wouldn't hurt a thing. You called me a liar. I saw it. Amos Slade, that Tipper's going to get you into trouble someday. Tipper. Woman, you ain't seen my temper. I catch him on my property again, I'll blast him, and next time I won't miss.
What was that?
That's
from
a pretty long clip.
I'm a 90s baby, so I grew up watching Disney VHS, the original.
Yeah.
VHS.
It's been a long time for me, but
that was
Fox and the Hound, right?
Yes, Fox and the Hound.
Was that one of your favorites that you would watch a lot?
I was just going to ask that.
Yeah, sure was. Fox and the Hound, Aladdin, Alice in Wonderland.
Can you do some Aladdin?
I don't believe it! Okay.
Oh,
that was,
nice.
That was.
You got a Gilbert Gottfried thing going on, don't you?
Yeah, I was trying to do his voice, but I can't.
Oh, if you workshop that and practice it, I'll bet you could do the parrot.
Dude, the fact that Jeff recognized that is pretty impressive. Like, if you can do something and someone recognizes it even just a little bit.
Oh, I grew up with it. That's all you need. Watch Aladdin until the tape broke. Cracked in half.
Oh, shit.
And so, Josh, is your album released only on a cassette tape?
Yes, at the moment.
Was there a reason, is there a particular reason why you're doing that, not on CD?
That's just what Deathbed Tapes does. I don't criticize it. I just appreciate it. That's sick. I got my own record deal, man.
Yeah, I feel that.
I think you're either going to get it digitally, you're going to download it from them, or if you want the novelty of playing it on a tape, a cassette, you're going to buy it. Because there's a subset of people that just love that. They love having tapes.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. Cobra's thoughts exactly. Retro is in.
Retro man.
Yeah.
Josh, who taught you how to play guitar? Your guitar?
My two guitar teachers I had growing up in Valley City, North Dakota, John Rudolph and Zach McGough. After my guitar teachers.
Oh.
Was his name Zach McGough?
Zach McGough, yeah. And then
McGough? Like McGough.
McGough, yeah.
Okay.
It's like an Irish Gothman.
McGough tattoo parlor who did my first tattoo, which is the Cobra Gram on my right arm.
Were you going to get the Monster logo sometime soon, Cobra?
Yes, on my left shoulder.
Nice.
Jason's my Cradle of Filth tattoo. It'll be a green Monster M.
How many tattoos do you have?
Four.
nice.
You were thinking about getting the all-seeing eye somewhere on your forehead, between your eyes. Is that right?
No way.
Yes, I want to get it between my eyes, like between my eyebrows, and like glow in the dark ink.
Oh, yeah.
Are you serious?
When the black light hits, it'll be like, ooh, 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 you know?
Yeah.
Like the lines and then the actual legit eye, like it looks like on the dollar bill, kind of. Yeah.
Are you a little nervous about getting a face tattoo?
Not really. Like I said, it won't show up during the day. It'll only show up when there's black.
Okay. So it'll be invisible unless you're in darkness.
It's literally just an invisible eye.
Oh, that's so cool, Cobra.
You don't have any on like your neck or your back?
Nope, not yet.
Give
Are you
time.
Planning on doing like a full body eventually?
I don't know my whole body, but I definitely want more tattoos. Like I want demon wings on my back and shit.
They're addicting, huh? The tattoos?
Yeah, they're fun to get and they turn out cool when you go to the right artist.
I fucking hate needles unless they're leaving behind ink.
Taking a sip with you right now, Joe.
I have a
rock and roll.
Rock and roll!
Rock and roll, baby.
Space is back!
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I almost hit that page Cobra's when I was magic. In the car. Almost.
Fuck rape.
Fuck rape.
Cobra, I want to play a game.
Getting your eyeliner, your goth eyeliner tattooed on?
You want to play a game?
I want to play a game, Josh.
Play a game.
I want to play a game. All right. So, you're Jigsaw, okay? Or maybe Josh is. I'm sorry. Sean is Jigsaw. But... You've got a convicted Chimo in a barn somewhere. Uh-oh. He's all tied up, right?
Yes.
What would you do? What kind of game would you play with him? I can give you some time.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
I'd put in a brain-eating parasite that would take like days to finish him off.
Yeah.
Damn.
And then I'd take, like, the sound of whining puppies and beat him with a bull whip while he listened to it.
Like, what the fuck?
I got you. That's amazing. Well, whining puppies, you said, right?
Yeah,
because that's got to be annoying as fuck.
You would just die right away. I'd make it slow, agonizing, and painful.
Yeah. And then the brain parasite. That's pretty good. So he'd have a lot of time to think about what he did, huh?
Exactly. I hate
while he listens to whining puppies.
Well, then I hate
which
puppies.
It's going to make it worse.
Yeah, you'd have to make him feel as powerless as he makes his victims feel.
I've got, let's say a demon visits you in the dead of the night and he says, I'm going to eliminate all Chimos on Earth. I'm going to get rid of all sickos.
If you give me
but I'm going to need something in exchange from you, Josh.
And I'll have coffee.
Let's see. I want to test your limits, okay?
Okay.
Would you give up your eyeballs?
Oh. Yes.
You wow. give up your eyeballs. Damn.
Damn.
That's pretty committed. I thought that was going to be a no, so I was going to lower the stakes a little bit. Jeez.
What's your reason behind that, though?
Your sense of hearing.
Yes.
Like your balls.
Yes, I give up my balls for that shit, too.
Amen. Amen. What if you had to get the Chomo treatment and have the brain virus and then die? Would you go that far?
If you had to give me a brain parasite to get rid of child molesters, I'd take
yep.
it.
Man, you have no limits when it comes to getting rid of them, do you?
No, I don't.
Ooh, that's pretty bold.
11 rules of the earth, rule number 9, motherfucker.
Oh, shit. 11 rules of the earth. That's from, what, LaVey or the Satanism stuff?
Satanic 11 rules of the earth.
Yeah, and what's number 9? Remind me.
Never hurt small children.
Oh, and that requires the worst punishments of them all, huh?
One of, yes.
I think you've talked about when you die, you've pictured yourself being in hell hanging out with Lucifer, right?
Yes, and becoming like a badass demon, one of his like top demons.
You would probably
my supernatural powers with me, and then they increase tenfold.
Yeah, you'd probably be punishing those trimos that got sent to hell, huh?
You already know what's up, dude. I'd be punishing assholes.
Can I ask you a question, Josh? Why don't you use your powers against them now? Is that because you want to still let karma just do its own work, or?
Oh, I've been casting.
You know, so even if you do it against something bad, don't you still get it back threefold to you?
What's that?
Let's say you're going around casting spells only against people like, chomos. Doesn't it come back to you threefold?
It can, but in a good way, depending on what you're using your magic for.
So if you're using it to kill, to fuck with people that fuck with kids, obviously that's for a good cause.
Yes.
So you're not going to get bad karma then doing that?
No. Use your magic for good and good will come to you.
So why are you doing that now then? Do you cast?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
In his powers would increase tenfold is what he said when he goes to hell. So, I mean, he's got them already. They're just going to be amplified when he gets to rub elbows with Lucifer and hang out.
Right. Do you have, a sex offender list? You just go down randomly and just start picking them off?
No, it's just fucking all legit. Because there are some assholes who get caught peeing in the park, and they're on the sex offender list. Doesn't say
what. Yeah, that's right. That's right. I am so proud to know that you actually have that you differentiate like that. No, you're not just going all willy-nilly down the list just fighting people.
Changed it because people are going around and killing pedophiles, and I'm like, why'd you change it, assholes?
I have another test of your limits, all right, Cobra? I started with the physical stuff. We're going to get a little weird with it, all right?
All right.
Would you deeply and passionately kiss another man to end Chimos?
Ooh, good question.
Yes.
Only because you want to get rid of him.
Only because
I want to. I can almost hear him throwing up.
Oof. All right. I'm going to escalate, okay? And this is all theoretical, and I know that your intentions are good. I just want to see how far you'll go. Would you have sex with another man to get rid of Chimos?
Wait a minute. Can I interject?
That's a test, man. It's a test.
Yeah.
You have to be more specific.
Gross and weird about it because I'm not into gay sex, but I would do it.
Can I add something to this? Can you be a little bit more specific, Jeff? In your, is he giving it or receiving it?
He'd be giving it.
Okay, yeah. So then the question is: Would you butt fuck a guy to get rid of chomos?
Not in those words, exactly.
Oh, come on.
I think he got it loud and clear.
Some of my audience and myself,
they need it spelled out for them. Yeah.
Yes.
Verbatim.
Yeah, for us idiots. Okay.
Dude, I would get rid of cobras, every last fucking cobra on the planet, including king cobras, to end chimos. I would give up my sex life.
Whoa.
Give up alcohol. I'd give up marijuana.
Whoa.
Yeah. I mean, it's important to him. Seriously, he'd give up a lot.
I give up my fucking dream house to end child molestation. I can never build it, ever.
What is made you
give up?
Do you have someone, a friend or something that experienced something that close to you and to your heart that has you so vehemently against them? Not that they're. I mean, I get the whole why you'd be against them first of all, but more so. I mean, you would give up your favorite fucking your spirit animal. You know what I mean? To end it. So. I was just wondering, if you have someone who you love that.
Well, I'll just say I know some people that have been through some shit. And
right.
You hear about their stories, and then you see the way they are as adults now, and it's fucking sad, dude.
And how, stunting it is to their life, right?
Pretty much, dude.
Yeah. Yeah, no,
Cobra, I've got another test for you. This is demon number two, okay? He visits you in the dead of the night. And he says, King Cobra, I've got a question for you. I've got some dark powers I can bestow upon you. Now, I can give you all the powers you've ever wanted. You will be a god, essentially, on this earth. But you've got to give up your dad. He's going to take him to hell with him. Would you offer that sacrifice?
No, I wouldn't, because I love my dad, and he's a part of the family unit, you know? We fight sometimes, but he's my dad. I couldn't do it, dude.
Attaboy, Josh. I'm proud of you. Good answer.
Even though we fight sometimes, it'd be like, it's just typical father-son shit, you know?
You're supposed to fight with your parents. That means they're doing a good job.
Definitely. Yeah. You know, there was a song you put out that had Clint in it, and he was kind of harping on you. I think it was because you'd been playing GTA, right?
No, it wasn't because I was playing GTA, to be honest.
Oh, okay. My bad. I've been wondering, because, you know, he's really emotional in that clip, right?
Yeah, I know the song you're talking about.
Yeah. I've been really curious. What was going on? Are you able to tell us?
Yeah. My dad was worried that I'd become some kind of psychopath who loves guns and violence and hates women. That's not necessarily the case. I don't hate women. I don't hate men. I hate people equally. I try to give them a fair chance. I find out they were sicko, and I'm like, I'm done with your shit, dude. I don't judge people outside of that. And... yeah.
Any specific incident? Did he find something? I mean, sometimes people doodle all kinds of crazy stuff just to see what they can draw. Did he maybe find some, like, some weird stuff you've been working on?
Yeah, I was working on concepts for my cartoon, and then they mistook it a certain way, you know.
Yeah. They've got to understand.
Like that. No offense to my parents, I love them, but they grew up as construing a lot of the shit that I did.
Yeah. I mean, kids are kids. They're going to do weird things. I know I did. Yeah. I'm just glad they didn't find it, a lot of the stuff that I was doing. They didn't pry too deep. I mean, I guess it probably started with the Cobra religion and kind of being really heavy into that. You kind of got on their radar, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What does your dad think of your fuck your sky god, I'm a god theory?
He supports me. I mean, like, growing up, it was like, oh, Josh thinks he has powers. So they're taking me to all these fucking head doctors, these med doctors, these shrinks. And I'm just like, okay, looking back on it now, if I'd have been a Christian, they wouldn't have said shit. But now my dad doesn't care. He just wants what's best for me, you know, and I can respect that.
I read... the Reddit subreddit that your dad wrote on, and I fucking just fell in love with your dad. I thought your dad was just so awesome.
Reddit, man.
And I'm envied you that you have a dad that cares so much like that.
Subreddit impersonating him is just dumb shit.
Yeah, we try not to talk about the sub here.
Oh, shit, sorry.
Yeah. Josh.
What's that?
Hey, boy. You remember in Dragon Ball how you had to have a pure heart to reach certain levels of Super Saiyan?
Mm-hmm.
Would you say you have a pure heart?
Yes.
All right. I am a fellow anime lover. Josh, you talked about Tenshi Muyo.
Yes. Ooh, with the pink hair. Ryoko's such a pervert. I love it.
Which one was your favorite?
A Little Washu was my favorite as a kid. I like Ryoko. Yeah. My buddy Eric grew up watching the same TV show, and we went to this after-school program, MASH, together, and he liked Ryoko, and I was like, yeah, this show's perverted.
Did you have a crush on her? I think you mentioned something like that once.
Yeah, when you were a kid, you know, like, yeah. These cartoon characters, like Poison Ivy from the original animated Batman, Merry Christmas, Darling, you know, and, like, you see Poison Queen, and, like, Sailor Pluto, and, you know, yeah, dude. Little Washu and shit like that. You don't have any what it is. You just know, hey, you like that gender.
She had the tan. She was kind of tan and had really dark green hair, right?
No, Little Washu was the one with the pink hair.
No, I'm sorry. Sailor Pluto.
Oh, no, she was. Yeah, she might have been tan or white. I don't fucking remember, but she had, like, dark green hair, yes.
Yeah. I think that was my favorite, too. You watching any anime these days, boyo?
No, I'm not. But there's a website where you can watch anime for free.
Oh, yeah.
I'll look it up in private chat. You get all your favorite shows for free.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. No, maybe you can get back into it. There's all kinds of stuff like Tenshi. They call them harem animes. Lots of cute women.
Right.
Yeah, yeah. That's right.
You get free cartoons with no ads right here.
No ads.
All the cartoons, all the animes, all like Family Guy and SpongeBob and shit. I put that in the private chat here so y'all can look at that.
Yeah. Yeah, man. I wind up illegally downloading it through something called torrenting.
We don't even got to do that with this website.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I mean, I just data hoard. I mean, I've got gigantic hard drives full of pirated stuff. I just hang on to it. I love it.
Nice.
Yeah. Yeah, Josh. How's the? Did you finish that drink combo already? Honestly, I'm still working on my coffee.
Yeah, I did.
Open my drink yet?
Another one.
I'm thinking about having a little something. Yeah, maybe a little booze. We can drink on something together.
For sure.
Yeah,
hey, Josh, you're a Monster fan, right?
Yes, I love Monster.
What is your favorite flavor of that?
The original green one.
Have you tried Peachy Keen?
No, I haven't, but that sounds good. I tried the one you're drinking right now. That shit's good.
Yeah, it is. It tastes like a pixie stick, huh? Kind of. Well, like apples. The purple one's really good, too.
Purple,
but
purple.
Seriously, there is no better one than the Peachy Keen. It's brand new. You really ought to try that.
Hell yes, man.
Might need to drain the snake, and then I'm going to get some booze, and I'll be back, and maybe we can have a little drink combo together, Cobra.
Sounds groovy.
Hell yeah, I'll be right back. Cobra, you feeling a little shy right now? I don't have much room to talk, but your camera's been off.
Yeah, I'm feeling kind of shy. I'm sorry, guys.
Hey, you don't got to apologize, friend. You've been great. I was going to say, it's been really fun talking with you.
Yeah, enjoy the company.
Yeah.
I've been a terrible host, and I apologize. I'm just...
Yeah, shame on you.
I know, for real, seriously, but my job is on the
line. Stop that. You have not been a terrible host. Stop that.
Okay, thank you. You hear that, you asshole? I've been not been a terrible host.
He came on camera just to let you know that.
I know. Yeah, I know he knows, but I know that he means business when he fucking turns the camera on. Because he gets close to it, and I'm like, oh, he's about to tell me what's up right now.
Had his drink in hand, saying cheers.
I just want to let you know, Cobes, that I was not shaving my armpits for a while, and then I heard your rant, and I said, okay, fine, I'm going to, and so I shaved my armpits.
You don't have to shave if you don't want to, love. It's your pits. Fuck the patriarchy, man.
Yeah, but I kind of feel like if I didn't shave my armpits, then I would be ashamed by men.
Yeah. We still got that one going. That's awesome.
Made a second one, to be honest with you.
Oh, that's good stuff, man. More G Fuel, right?
Yeah, same combo as last time. G Fuel.
Perfect. Perfect, man. Yeah.
That drink combo is a slapping.
Cobra, you remember the night that you got possessed by a demon? It's been a long time.
I just watched that.
I really wasn't possessed by a demon that night when Chris came up with his brothers. I was just really drunk and figuring shit out, and I figured out, you know.
Oh, okay. No, man, I got you. I mean, if you were, like, blackout drunk, I could see someone kind of transforming a little bit.
Yeah.
Dude, I turn into a demon whenever I'm on my period.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I'm just gonna keep it real. Like, that's just the truth, you know?
Yeah.
Shrill, shrieking shrews on their period.
The roar.
Yeah.
Just there's nothing a guy can do correct. There's nothing anybody can do the right way.
Give her a ball of tequila rose and a bath bomb.
Tequila rose is so good.
Is there anything that you're saving up your money for, Josh? Like a big purchase besides the dream house?
What's that?
Are you saving up your money for anything lately?
Not really, just kind of if I need for anything, you know.
Yeah, yeah. I remember for a while it was the car. You wanted a, I think for in the early days you wanted a hearse, I think.
Yeah, 59 Cadillac Superior Crown Royal end loader, all black hearse.
Yeah.
428 Shelby Cobra jet engine dual exhaust.
Damn. 50s.
That or I'd build a Model T C cab rat rod hearse.
Would you ever get a like a scooter?
I've had a motorized scooter with A-pingers, man. That shit was fun.
Yeah. You got into an accident once, right? Someone bumped into you.
Yeah, I was on the way to work, and they knocked me off my scooter, but I had an angle where I just rolled.
Man, I think for getting around town and stuff, because you can ride that legally even without a license, can't you?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, man. Would you ever get another?
I thought about it, yes. I got my bike for that, to be honest.
Oh, okay. Yeah, you still got your bike. Oh, I've been picturing you on a scooter going wherever you want. Because, again, you don't need a license. And, I mean, Casper, from what I've seen, the traffic isn't so crazy that it would be dangerous. Oh, shit.
Right there. Boom.
Yeah. Oh, you got to give me some warning before you do that, Cobra.
Nah.
I came out of nowhere.
G-ball, motherfucker. I saw that shit boom up here. That was cool.
Damn. Did someone in chat ask for that, or did you just do that?
I just did that because someone texted me, hey, man, give us a G-ball.
Attaboy, G-ball. Any spells you could cast? Maybe some circles of protection? Maybe for Crystal here on her hair?
I just fucking got.
She needs it.
I just got a text. They removed that. I'm not working that shift tomorrow.
For her hair, she dyes it. So much they be.
You're very lucky, Crystal, to get one of those.
Yeah, I'm. Thank you so much.
Not everybody.
Thank you for having me on your show. It's been fun.
Oh, yeah. You're amazing. Thank you.
Fuck yeah.
This has been so much fun. You've been such a good sport. And I got starstruck, and then I fucking just lost my ass the whole time.
No worries, Mon.
If you could have a superpower, I'm going to give you a choice. We got another demon visit, okay?
Mm-hmm.
You can turn invisible, have telekinesis, or be super strong like the Hulk. Which would you choose?
Mm. That is tricky because I'd love to have all three of those, to be honest.
Oh, the sampler. Yeah. You can get that option, but you can only do each one for 5 minutes at a time.
I'll go with that then.
Not bad. That dude that gave you the boot over at CY Bar, would you have hulked out on him? Show him what's what?
Frosty's, not really.
Frosty's, I'm sorry. That's like, not CY Bar.
Yeah, you're good. No, I wouldn't, unless he took a swing at me, that's the only time I would have attacked, to be honest. Like, the bartender wasn't getting mad about it. I wasn't getting mad about it. I was pretty much trying to ignore them and enjoy my time at Frosty's. The only one who had a problem with it was the fucking asshole who was drinking.
It was pretty fucked up.
Telling me to get the fuck out, and I'm like, dude, leave me alone. He's like, no. I'm like, no, it is what it is. Happy Halloween. Fuck the trolls.
Yeah, man. Well, if anything good came out of that, I think we learned that, regrettably, you just have to not say where you're at because trolls are going to be jerks and call the place.
Yeah, no shit.
It sucks. Are there any bars left that you would be able to go to?
Yeah, there's a couple. Casper's got a couple bars, you know.
Okay. Good. I miss the old vids of you hanging out at the bar, you know, out in the wild. It's just fun to see you out there.
I'm a wild man, I feel a good time. Ooh, ooh. Cobra strike, fighting through the night. Ooh, ooh. No one's gonna stop me or slow me down. Feel I'm a cobra strike.
Shit, man. You're catching me off guard with these. You did Chi-Ball from left field, vocal cover, coming at me. Have mercy.
This is just a song I thought off the top of my head. It really wasn't a cover of anything.
Oh, my bad. It sounded like a real ass song. Shit.
It's a combination of different songs, just kind of.
Oh, okay. Riffing, yeah.
Yeah.
Someone in chat asked if you've ever been to a strip club.
No, I have not.
Yeah. Did you ever go to one?
If I was in the mood and the moment was right, yes. And I was.
Yeah.
Clean. Had some singles. Clothes. Had some singles, clean clothes, my tactical soap. Smelling smexy.
Yeah. You know, if you were really hitting the bomb, tactical soap, I think you'd have a pile of women grinding up on you. They wouldn't know exactly.
The tactical soap products I've noticed, man. I get the beard oil and the cologne and the soap, and women love it, dude.
You're going to be getting a snail trail on you.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Make of each woman horny, it doesn't make them like want to fuck you on the spot, but like it gets the idea going. Like, hey, you know, they cannot legally make a product that just makes you want to fuck like an animal. So this, the effects of tactical soap are subtle.
It's subtle.
Yeah. And man, you got to test that out.
Products. Women have, no offense, Crystal, but women have all these fucking products that are designed specifically to make a man horny without using pheromones.
Yeah, no, I agree with you. My ex-boyfriend had this cologne that had pheromones in it, and it was, you couldn't really smell it until it got on his body and mixed with his own chemicals and his own pheromones, and then you could smell it. It was fucking, it got me into some trouble. Yeah. Exactly. That laugh is exactly.
Says it all right there.
Yes, absolutely. Yeah.
You got to try that out sometime. I wore
the tactical soap. I had Bond number one. I was at the Ozzy Osbourne concert in Denver, Colorado. It was like the last show he did before he had to cancel it due to the staph infection in his hand.
Oh, yeah.
I was worried about it. Why do you rub it on your clothes, if you don't mind me asking?
What's that?
Why do you rub it on your clothes? And is it like a bar of soap that you're rubbing on your clothes? Because you keep on mentioning different numbers.
No, it could be like a bar of soap. Like if I got like a tiny little sliver or like some like other stick cologne, I rub it on the clothes just for like an extra effect. So you got two different scents going at the same time.
It's a combination.
You ever think about putting like a sliver of it in your pocket?
Three. What's that?
You ever think about putting like a sliver of it in your pocket and like keeping it in your pocket on you?
Don't have to. Once I apply it, it just starts working.
I'm going to share. And oh, I'm sorry.
I get socially awkward with talking to women sometimes, but when I wear tactical soap, dude, I feel great. It's like having a wingman on your skin.
I've got some tech to share with you, Josh. This will blow your mind. Mm-hmm. I read about a guy. He was sharing his story of a, kind of a similar technique. It was in a forum from a long time ago. But he was collecting his ball sweat. All right? Now stay with me. He would put a tiny bag around his nuts and then get like a little twisty tie or like a rubber band and collect all the ball sweat over the day. What and the then, stay with me.
Sandwiches.
He would then mix it with his cologne and spray it on himself. And his theory was that in the ball sweat was pheromones.
Yeah.
And he would document women's reactions, which included them. He would see their eyes dilate when they smelled him. And they'd get really friendly. At the same time, other men would get aggressive with them and get pissy. So it was on a very primal level.
Yes.
Yeah, man.
So do you have that problem, Josh, when you're wearing all your fucking tactical, like you have two spells on at the same time? Do you have guys getting aggressive?
Like what he described as pheromones, tactical soap does that, but the effects are subtle. It's not enough to make other men around you aggressive, but they respect you and they notice you. Like, hey, this dude, you know what I'm saying? Whereas, so like,
basically, like, women are like,
hey, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Yeah. I'd call that.
In the video, if y'all want to check that out, that's my affiliate link and my coupon code to get 15% off. I love wearing it, dude.
Get yourself some tactical soap, brother.
I've been using chloroform as a perfume to get men. I guess I'm doing that wrong.
You've been getting a cut from that, Josh? The soap sales?
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
Yeah, I get paid every time people use my coupon code or my affiliate link or both.
That's awesome. That's awesome.
I love being an affiliate for Tactical Soap. Fuck the trolls, dude. They can suck Scott Carr's dick.
Josh, are you still practicing the old Cobra religion?
Yeah, I'm the fucking leader of it, dude.
Yeah, so, man. Okay. You haven't given it up.
No, dude, fuck that. Cobra Cult's the shit.
The original three, Cobratius, Cabrero, Cobraton, still relevant, still part of the lore, right?
To some degree, yes. They later revealed themselves to me as Satan, Lucifer, and the devil himself, which are three different deific forces that rule over hell.
Okay.
That was just to make sure, you know, I was on the up and up. But now that it's come forth, we have what we have today. And my powers have grown, otherwise I wouldn't have gotten so famous on YouTube.
Yeah. There might be some truth to your magic. Your wands always sell out. And I remember when you first started selling them, the trolls were saying, oh yeah, these aren't going to sell. And yet, I mean, they fly off the shelves when they're out. They're gone.
Real magic wands, dude.
Yeah.
From a real dude who does occult type shit. So yes.
But I thought doesn't the magic come within you though? Isn't the magic in you not necessarily, or do you infuse the wands first with magic and then?
I do not infuse the wands personally. I give you a vessel, a tool. You can put it on display or you can use it as magic. It's made to channel your natural energy.
It's a conduit.
Yes.
What about people who don't have that? Like if I buy a wand from you, does it come with instructions on how I'm supposed to charge it?
Not really, no. You just got to put the energy, you got to hold it, like envision the energy going into it. Like water flowing through a gentle stream on a warm summer day.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
So I should probably definitely like start learning how to like meditate and stuff like that. That's maybe like
poetry,
first.
Josh.
I've been trying to use my powers and like meditating to just center myself and like not lose my temper. And you see it on my videos recently, or like some shit will happen and I just brush it off like, whatever.
I've definitely seen it before. I think there was a night where I think you started to drop a drink or something and I thought, uh-oh, here it comes. And a little bit of the rage came out, Josh, and then it just stopped. And honestly, it was pretty impressive.
At the end of the day, you know what I'm saying? Like, I have struggles just like everybody else.
Yeah.
Nobody's fucking perfect, dude.
No.
And all these trolls were just like, oh my God, I reposted a video of him freaking out on my channel. Thank you. That helped me see what I look like when I rage quit and delete the video. And that's what I've used to like meditate and better myself.
Does it make you nervous sometimes when you're streaming? Because most people can delete it immediately. But because your trolls record everything on the fly, anything you do, you know, is going to be archived. Does that kind of put you on edge a little bit?
Not really. Excuse me, people have an unhealthy obsession with me.
Yeah.
Like my t-shirt says, my trolls are more obsessed with me than I am with Cobra.
Does it wear you down? Because like I've been on the internet for a really long time too, probably about as long, not near the popularity that you have. And
I've been getting bullied my entire life, hon, so it doesn't wear me down. I'm just bullied at this point.
You've gotten a lot more political over the years, right? Or at least you talk about social issues. Yeah, it's sometimes I get a little stressed out when I'm listening to it.
That's why I do the joke videos. Like, I want to take a break from like the political shit and just like be a funny motherfucker that likes to hang out on stream and make wands and dank drink combos. I don't care if y'all are friends with Seizure Robot. Just fuck my trolls, to be honest.
Yeah, fuck them. Josh, you and me, we've been having some fun. It's been a good conversation.
That it has, good sir.
Yeah.
And shout out to the fans. Thank you for sending G Fuel to my P.O. box. I appreciate it.
Yeah.
I've been consuming it slowly if I'm in the mood for Phase X, because someone told me it tasted like liquid Skittles. I'm like, oh, like some Sprite Tropical Remix from back in the day. Shoot, let me get on that.
Cobra, do you dream often?
Occasionally, yes.
I had one today, and it was pretty wild. I have a problem with sleeping in general. I'm kind of an insomniac, so falling asleep today was a rare treat. But, you know, when the dream resolves and then you wake up, you ever have that happen?
Yes. I know the feeling.
Yeah, that happened today, and it was awesome.
What'd you dream about?
Well, thank you for asking. It was about, I've been watching a show that deals with creating, like, cybernetic bodies. It's called Ghost in the Shell. It's an anime.
Yeah, I love Ghost in the Shell.
Really? You're a big fan?
Dude, I grew up watching it on Toonami, dude, with Dragon Ball Z and Tenchimuyu. Come on, I'm a 90s.
Oh, right on, dude. All right. So it kind of started borrowing concepts from that. I've had two dreams about that now. They're obviously just clearly being inspired, but it dealt with some software and some tech that was monitoring normal people and their brain waves and what they were dreaming about, and then people who were they've been cyberized. They had robot bodies. And it makes me kind of sound like a crazy person talking about this, but have you heard of sleep paralysis?
Oh, that's scary.
You say you have Cobra?
Yes, I have.
It's scary, man. People talk about hearing like a screaming voice and stuff. What were you gonna say?
I made another G Fuel drink, just like the last one, number three.
Oh, you're going hard, Cobra.
Go big or go home.
Cobra's Fog. New drink combo, making history tonight.
Oh, what are you going to call this?
What were you saying, Crystal?
What is going to be the name of this particular drink combo?
Cobra's Fog.
You already came up with that from before.
Yeah, he's been drinking it. Yeah, getting wild. Mm-hmm. Check that out. Yeah, sleep paralysis is really scary. There's lucid dreaming, where you can take full control over the dream.
I mastered lucid dreaming. When I turn into it, I can fucking share that.
You can just kind of set it to be whatever you want, right?
Yes.
Have you ever done that, Jeff?
Several times. I love lucid dreaming.
That's amazing.
People who were harassing me.
The only time I can remember where it wasn't because it was really scary and I was just able to make things happen in the dream, I will be straight with you. I made a sexy lady appear and it was awesome.
Yeah, I've done that before. I've made of age women appear in my dreams that I've never met.
If you could,
for it, you know, your mind manifests it.
Yeah. If you were lucid dreaming, what would the dream woman look like? Literally and figuratively, a dream woman.
I've got enough discussed on YouTube.
That's all right. Do you have a boob limit on how big they are? Is there a point where you say enough is enough?
Playing with my beer bottles.
What? All right.
You don't even know, dude. Like, I'm just sitting here on stream and I hear the beer bottles jiggle in the kitchen and I'm like, do the ghosts from my old apartment follow me here or do I have
a... Is it Winston?
They can do that.
Either or. Winston, you bastard.
Oh, he's at it again. He found you.
Kinesis energy, just enjoying the night.
Yeah. He's jealous. He wants to have fun with you again. And Sean.
I told the ghost in my old apartment, you can stay here, you can come with me. I don't care, dude. We're pretty chill, you know.
Yeah.
He could be a distant relative of mine, to be honest with you. King Cobra JFS is related to the McNeils, which is a Scottish clan. Their clan colors are shit you not, black and green. And it's pretty fucking sick. I actually am descended from that Viking ancestry.
All right.
And then someone named McNeil used to live in my old apartment, so I thought that was kind of cute. I'm like, ain't that a quinky dink?
Well, it's like, almost too much of a coincidence.
That's what I'm saying, dude. Yeah. Like, trip like that.
What kind of stuff would Winston do? I think one time the toilet seat fell down real hard in one of the videos.
He'd knock Sean off the shelf. He'd knock the toilet seat down. You know, he'd fuck with shit in my apartment just to get my attention. Like, hey, fucker, I'm here. And
Yeah.
It would have been a poltergeist I might have accidentally summoned due to all my demonic magic that I practiced and shit.
Maybe at some point, if you're really, you know, starting to think something's up, bust out that Ouija board and see if they're trying to talk with you.
Oh, the Ouija board I have has such powerful energy associated with it, because you've seen that fucker on the Now It's a Party documentary.
Yeah.
People are like, oh, Cobra talks about doing this and that, and like legitimately you saw like a walk into Highland Cemetery, hashtag respect the dead, and a huge fucking raven just flies over our fucking heads, and like this guy's just some like dark magic shit, and like fucking using it for the right purposes, and holy shit, it's working.
Trying to think of how to describe this. Some people just have an air about them where things start to go haywire or crazy. Would you say you have really good luck or really bad luck?
I'd say I'm pretty neutral. So it just depends on the situation and the things, you know.
Do you think that spirits are drawn to you no matter where you go?
Oh, yes. I'm very sensitive to the spirits.
Yeah.
Josh, you mentioned doing spice at one point in time in your life. Did you ever have any? Did you find that like you had more susceptibility to being able to sense stuff like that when you were under the influence of spice?
Yes and no. I regret ever trying it, to be honest.
Oh, so it wasn't something like you did regularly.
No.
It was just a one-time deal.
Yeah.
Yeah. You better off smoke the weed, man.
Yeah.
The green smoke to the black flame. The black flame.
Amen.
Lucifer's light.
Pardon me, goodness. How's the phrase go? The
black flame to light my green smoke.
Thank you. Thank you. I always get them mixed up. You're quite like a dum-dum.
Don't worry about it, man. It's
oh, all thank you. Thank you.
It's like where's Rastafarianism or Satan. It's like a little bit of magic.
Well, that's a dank combo right there.
Yeah, my.
Yeah. Have you seen Darflinny lately?
No, I haven't, but I've been trying to hang out with him.
Yeah. I was watching.
For him to smelt.
Yeah, he's smelting cans. I'm sure, you know, could always bring him some. And
I got like 4 bags of cans for him to smelt.
Nice. Nice.
Yeah. Well, at least my drunk ass can contribute to recycling, you know.
Yeah. I was watching the egg video recently that you did with Darf.
Exactly.
Exactly. That is a great video.
Oh, I have a question about the Mountain Dew soaked eggs.
Yes, go for it.
Did you ever eat those?
Yes, I did.
Were they disgusting?
No, they weren't.
Really?
It's still like Mountain Dew, salt, and sugar.
Yeah. And hot sauce, too, right?
Yes.
Yeah, there you go.
The jalapeno hot sauce. Complimented
and spicy.
Dude, so nicely.
Did it take a long time to get all the egg shells off?
It did, because I didn't soak it in cold water.
Hmm.
Let's add maybe water after you boil them and the shell will just come right the fuck off.
You remember when you got Thai food sent to you?
I do remember that shit.
That green curry, yeah?
Yeah, it was good.
Man, you devoured that green curry.
Yeah.
What I want to know is who sent it? Who sent the green curry?
No fucking idea, man.
I'm still trying to crack that case. Who sent the green curry, Cobra?
No, I have no idea, dude.
You'll eat almost anything. You're not, like, a picky eater.
Oh, I am.
It's a great way to experience other people's cultures, you know. Their music, yeah. Food.
Would you eat, like, a tarantula? Deep-fried tarantula?
Mm-hmm.
He's no. Eating bugs. He's eating water bugs.
I try it.
Yeah.
It'd take me a second to be like, oh, you know, I think spiders are cool. I'm not scared of them, to be honest. Well, if I was in Australia, maybe it'd be a different story. But
what about like a big hissing cockroach?
Down under fans and all my fans.
I mean, when he ate the surstromming, for one, which is most people can't eat that, but Cobes went for it. And then the water bugs. I mean, it's hard to get more difficult than that. He will eat anything. Not anything, but he's not picky.
Mm-hmm.
It's impressive. A lot of people with autism, they're called super tasters. And you can even get little tasting strips that only they can taste, and it'll taste really nasty. And that's why you get the really picky eaters who only eat things like French fries, is because they're super tasters. And usually they're on the spectrum as well. They're autistic. But I'd say it's kind of a blessing, Josh. You said you hadn't heard of that?
Yes, I have heard of that.
Spectrum
internet.
Yeah. But you, Spectrum, I just got it. That was a thinking man's joke. That took me a second.
You're good, man.
Yeah. But no, you don't have like a hypersensitive palate, which I think is honestly a blessing, because you're not restricted to just eating something like one food, like mac and cheese or, again, French fries.
Right.
Some people are really stuck with that.
Love pizza and bacon cheeseburgers, but I can eat other things.
Oh, yeah. You can eat all kinds of stuff. Is there anything that you really don't like eating?
The sticky fruit, durian, whatever that is.
Yeah. A lot of people have problems with that. I've been wanting to try it. It's really expensive.
Like candies that were flavored like that and just straight up tasted like Asperger's.
I think someone said that it tastes like fruit, but also like onions and garlic and stuff. It's savory.
What's that? Or a Babe Ruth candy bar?
The durian fruit. The
durian candies were gross, dude.
Yeah, yeah.
So fucking gross. Off in my cupboard, I might try one on camera just for like, oh, what the fuck, Cobra, you know what I'm saying?
What about the ghetto grape eggs? I remember that one was a little rough.
Those actually didn't taste half bad.
Yeah. It's
salty with like a hint of grape.
Oh. Do you think you could try them again? Maybe now that some time has passed?
If I have the ingredients to make it, yeah.
I'm sure someone can send you some ghetto grape. Easy.
For sure.
Yeah, man. Yeah. I mean, sometimes I've eaten things in the past I didn't like, and later on they're good. But the ghetto grape and the egg, at least at the time, I think it didn't go down too well in the video, if I'm remembering it right.
Mm.
Yeah.
I don't remember, to be honest.
That's all right. It was like a hard-boiled egg, and then you like sprayed some ghetto grape on it, and it was a not-so-dank combo.
Oh, yeah. No, okay, no, I know. Oh, yeah, the ghetto grape spray. That's for like your tobacco papers.
Yeah, you got it.
I don't remember. Yeah, that shit was weird. I'm like, you're supposed to spray this on tobacco to make it taste like grape, not put it on your food, you fucking wanker.
You'll try anything, though. I mean, you like to experiment. That's what drink combos are all about.
What can I say? I'm just like, yes. It's no worse than the Tide Pod Challenge, which came fucking years after that video.
Yeah. No, fortunately, you don't do anything that actually endangers you or can be a risk to your health, like eating Tide Pods. That's ridiculous.
No, I'd fuck with the fucking poisonous King Cobra and blow weed in his face and be like, I'm fucking with the wild cobra, I'm King Cobra JFS, what's up? If I get bit, it'd be an way to go out.
Have you been able to meet a cobra in real life?
Closest I came was the Reptile Gardens in Nemo, South Dakota. They had a Malaysian King Cobra on display. They had an Indian cobra in their show. And it was just like, oh, I spurred so hard.
Yeah.
Here's perfect snake.
What's your earliest memory of being fascinated with cobras?
My childhood, playing Buzzy the Knowledge Bug on a Windows 98 computer.
Nice.
And it was the jungle version. There was a cobra standing next to a peacock, so I got fascinated with both those animals just playing that game. I grew up in the generation of Harry Potter and like Steve Irwin, the jungle, not Buzzy the Knowledge Bug, you know.
Yeah.
90s nostalgia, baby.
So it was like one of those educational games.
Yeah, yeah.
I got you. Damn, and that's where it all began. It all started.
And then my aunt bought me a copy of Steve Irwin's Spitting Cobras of the World. And then there's like the first cobra he's fucking with is this big black forest cobra. And you're like, ooh, that's pretty. The second one's this big all black spitting cobra. And you're like, that thing looks mean. And you get the albino cobra, and then you get the lizard, and then the rest of it's just like little redneck spitting cobras kind of thing.
And you just knew right away when you saw it. Like, it was an immediate connection.
Yes, I love snakes. They're badass.
Is there, I mean, some people talk about, like, spirit animals and stuff, but do you think there's some part of you that, like, kind of borrows from the snake or, like, resembles?
To be honest.
It's spiritual.
Yeah, we all have animals that we spiritually connect with, and it's in a totem, so to speak. It's like the natives preach.
Some people joke.
Because, like, crows and ravens also love me, dude.
Yeah. Yeah, I've seen a lot of videos of you talking to crows.
And snakes, especially, like, just like dogs and cats and animals in general, you know.
Yeah. No, you get along real well with animals. Sometimes they just, I don't know if it's like the smell or something else, but they seem to like you a lot.
Because animals are subject to cruelty by humans, and humans can be shit. I've been bullied by people, and I sense that humans can be shit sometimes.
Yeah.
And they pick up on that.
They can tell if you're uncomfortable.
I am humans, to be honest.
Yeah, well, I mean, they pick up on cues. So if you're really comfortable with them and they can't detect it, I'm sure they really like you.
I make friends with the meanest dog on the block, dude.
Yeah, man.
He's never like that with anyone. This dog kind of thing, you know? I'm just like, yeah, I'm good with animals. It's just one of...
I think crows had a significant part with the Vikings. I may be misremembering that, but I thought that they would, or at least in like Norse mythology, crows were a big part.
Correctly.
Yeah. And they had kind of a symbiotic relationship. They would help each other out, and crows could like point out things to them. They had them tamed back then.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Well, that's like shit.
Pigeons.
Did you know that crows pass down information from one generation to another? So they did an experiment where a guy was wearing a mask or something, and he was just a dick to crows.
I fed crows in my area some hard-boiled egg, and they recognized me, dude. I step outside to have a cigarette, and I'll see a crow flying over, and they're just like... It's this guy.
Eggs? You were feeding him eggs?
Yeah, I know I'm being trolled by some people. I don't care.
No, it caught me off guard, man, with the eggs. Something about the eggs is really funny to me. You know, it's one of those things. It's kind of like farts. You don't know why it's funny. But hard-boiled eggs makes me laugh every time. Hard-boiled
chicken eggs.
Chicken eggs. Yeah, man. Do you just have them in your pocket or something?
No, I make them.
No, I'm sorry, but like when you were feeding the crows, like you just... All right, man. I'm sorry. I don't... Chat's been pretty good, I think. They haven't been too mean. There's always going to be some trolls in there, but... Oh, God. Did they like the eggs?
Mm-hmm.
Nice, man. I mean, technically, it is a unfertilized. Yeah.
And when I step up for a cigarette and I see a crow and they see me flying as they do flying by, they caw and I caw back.
Yeah. They're saying, hey, you're kind of part of the family after enough time when they all get to know you.
Casper crows love me. They recognize me.
They know you. So that's King Cobra.
Goth, warlock, badass motherfucker.
That's right. They're your familiars. Got those crows. You ever see the movie The Crow?
Mm-hmm.
Do you like it?
Yes.
It's like the quintessential. Yeah, sorry, man. I'm getting excited talking to you. I'm getting into it. I don't mean to cut you off.
No, you're good. I appreciate the fan support.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. What can the fans do to show you some love and appreciation? What do you like the most from your fans?
Just tuning into my videos, to be honest.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, buying a t-shirt, buying a wand, donating to PayPal, or buying tactical soap, that's a bonus to what I do.
Oh, yeah.
Sit there on Courtney's stream like, oh, check out Crystal's big tits. And I'm like, yeah, they're nice, but that's a bonus. I got a chick who supports me, which was more important.
What the fuck? He just pulled me right out of my...
You're good, Courtney.
Thank you for the compliment, Coach.
How's the hair coming along?
I was just going to cut in and ask, do you think I've had this on for long enough? Because, like, my scalp is tingly.
When did you start?
I don't remember. I got starstruck.
Oh, get that out ASAP. It's just the dye, right? It's not the bleach.
Yeah, no, I don't have the bleach in.
Oh,
thank God. I lost the job. I lost the shift tomorrow, so I don't know. This is kind of like for nothing, but.
Oh, well, get that out. It's been at least 2 hours, right?
Yeah, I'm going to.
Crystal, you've done it again.
I know. I'm an idiot. I don't know what to say.
Oh, you just get distracted easy. Get that.
Man, no one's perfect.
No one's perfect. It's just a little spooky, Cobra, because 2 hours of having that die-in can cause problems. At least 2 hours. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Good Lord. Well, you got to show us on cam, Crystal, the end result, okay? Got to do the big reveal. Well, Josh, remember when...
Favorite anime, Bleach?
My favorite anime?
No, I said, what was Crystal's hair's favorite anime? I'm sorry, that was really a true joke.
That's a good one.
Yep.
Hey, that was funny, Crystal. I know you're probably in a sour mood right now because you're worried about your hair, but that was funny.
It'll be fine, love. You're a female. Who gives a fuck? Your hair's short. That's why the fucking... The shit with Will Smith pissed me off because, like, Chris Rock, it's like, dude, you're a guy. No one gives a fuck if you got hairy armpits or not, you know? Like, it's just this automatic gender assumption, like, gender stereotype that women have to be shaved. And it's like, if guys are into non-shaved, they get called misogynistic pigs. And it's just a circle jerk of bullshit. It's like, women can choose whether or not they want, and when, you know what I'm saying? And, like, dudes can choose whether or not, like, hey, you know.
I mean, on the flip side, you've talked about it before, Cobra. You'll kind of groom a little bit down there, right?
You gotta keep my King Cobra peep free. I shave that shit.
Yeah, and that's your choice. I mean, that's not like a typical male thing to do, but you go for it.
Yeah.
I think you shared some really funny stories back in the day when you were doing wrestling. I think they said you had, like, King Kong down there.
Bear attacking your car. I'm like, what the fuck are you looking at my shit, bro? Yeah.
Yeah. Hey, you got to keep that under control. Otherwise, it's just a little mushroom tip poking out. That's all you can see. And get a big old mouthful of that.
I got shag nanigans because you look like a shag nasty.
Shag nasty shit heel.
Yeah.
Ooh. Yeah, man. Is that? I mean, you go to town all over, don't you? Or is it just like down there?
I go over town wherever I'm needed or wherever I need to go. Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
100%. Yeah.
You still doing any weightlifting or anything like that?
I got weights in my apartment, so if I feel like doing it, I'll just do it.
Yeah. Would you ever get a gym membership for like $10 a month?
If I feel good vibes from the gym, absolutely.
That's amazing. I Man, what I would give to see a gym stream. That would be...
blasting, like, my music on my headphones while I
stream. Yeah.
That'd be cool, dude.
I got to tell you, the women ain't bad either at the gym. I'm not creeping, but I try to keep the tunnel vision and not stare. But every now and again, you get a little tasty treat. I want you
to, they say don't stare, but let's like, have you seen the crap they go to the gym and when they work out, they're showing up.
It's a little distracting sometimes.
Exactly.
Let's face it, we're men, Cobra.
Same time, look at my tits and my ass. I'm like, okay, so you don't stare, and then she's flirting with you, and you stare at her with you not looking, and just be cool about it. You know, that's how you do it.
Just be cool. Yeah, yeah. Focus on your training.
Like, I am training right now, Kakarots.
Exactly.
I'm not distracted by all these gym sluts.
You got to get in the gravity training machine and focus. Do 100 times gravity. Don't worry about
it. 100 times gravity, Kakarot.
Don't worry about the gym thoughts.
Exactly.
Yeah. Eyes on the prize.
Just put on a tactical soap, and like every gym thought you fucking walk by is going to be like you're sweating and you smell like tactical soap. You take a shower before you go to the gym. Oh, shit.
Yeah. Like, I bet you could get some big gains. I mean, big ass gains, Cobra. You've got it in you.
And getting chicks, man.
Yeah. Probably need some women there.
By natural genetics.
Yeah.
You know. Yes.
Getting that hyperbolic time.
I come from Vikings, military, and ranch hands as my ancestors.
That's right. That's right. Got the tough hands. You got that strong grip, don't you? Used to make a joke. If you ever got the... ranch sauce, ranch dressing on your hands. You'd say, does that make me a ranch hand? That's an old
joke. Yes, that joke. Yeah, little Cobra play on words.
It always lands with me. Makes me laugh every time.
Yes, like I'm eating a bacon cheeseburger with ranch, and like ranchers farm the beef and the bacon to make it, and then I get the ranch on my hand, and I'm just like, well, that makes me a ranch hand.
Yeah. Yeah, man.
It's a cheesy Cobra joke, but it lands because it's like I got relatives that are ranchers, and then like I don't
try
cowboy just because my ancestors are ranchers, man.
It's relevant.
Yeah,
it applies. How's your drink combo doing? You get to the bottom of that thing yet?
Still sipping on it. Yeah.
I might be getting a little more vodka for myself. Oh, there you go. Yes. I mean, people do Jaeger bombs all the time, right? They'll do Red Bull and Jägermeister. That's common.
Cobra's candy.
Cobra's candy. You know, I did some notes recently on all your drink combos.
Red Bull, pineapple juice, and
I've got a friend. That's his favorite combo that you make is Cobra's candy. I think even he wasn't sure on the name. Good. Yeah, Midori, pineapple.
Red Bull and Jack Daniels.
That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Is that one of your favorite combos?
Fuck yeah, it is. Cobra's candy's the shit.
That's a keeper right there.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. What?
I'm putting Professor Snape to shame because my potion-making skills are awesome and no one's to blame because I'm on top of my motherfucking game.
Cobra, anyone ever tell you that you are just legitimately good at freestyling?
Yes, I have. Thank you for asking. I try to be modest about it, to be honest.
You are very modest. It's
autistic.
I think
Eminem over here.
One of the best things you do is freestyling.
Yeah.
I can't do that. I think 98% of people can't freestyle like you can.
Cobra rocking mad denim. Sending him to hell on a shotgun shell. When they see him, put him on blast, and I'm feeling swell. See him when I'm laughing in hell. Spitting mad venom when the Cobra rocking denim.
Oh, shit. There you go. And you just produced that.
Uh-huh.
You just made that up. Easy. It's like breathing for you.
Yeah, that's the thing of it. Like, I'd have kids in Valley City go, hey, Josh, hey, Cobra, do a rap for us. And they'll be like, all right. I grew up watching Kangaroo Jack, you know, like the original from like 1990s, early 2000s version, where they made like the shampoo with the Australian berries, you know.
Cobra, I can make it so that instead of hearing my voice, you'll hear like a rap beat or something, or
Whatever, man. It's a crystal stream, whatever she's down with, you know, within reason, of course.
Yeah. No, man, put a beat on, get you rapping. Would you ever consider, I think the fans would love a rap album, if it was just you freestyling with some beats and stuff?
I might do a rap album, my next album, because Satan's Bell is just my sound. It's just beautiful fucking shit, dude.
Yeah.
My next album, I could try to make it more rap influenced, just to see where it goes.
I bet you could produce it pretty quick, too, because you're fast when it comes to coming up with freestyles. You could do like a 3-minute track with a beat, produce 12 of those, and just let it ride.
It's your gift, but at the same time, it's got a sadistic side effect.
Oh, yeah.
Dude, fuck yes.
Yeah, man. Maybe that'll be the next big one. You might really take off with the rap career.
Rap rock, whatever.
Rap rock, yeah. A new combo, new genre. What are your thoughts on the Juggalos?
Dude, I'm cool with Juggalos, Juggalettes, as long as you ain't a fucking sick fuck. It's fuck this beef between Eminem and ICP. It's fucking stupid. Y'all grew up in the same goddamn motherfucking state. Like, grow the fuck up and stop being children about it. Y'all supporting rap, hip-hop, what the fuck ever. Fucking rock, Snoop Dogg, some goddamn Eminem, some D12, and some ICP. And say, fuck the haters, bitch. Fucking slam some cotton candy Faygo and mix it with some cotton candy vodka and tell them to go fuck themselves. And all these motherfuckers who are sitting there, like these fuckers in ICP are getting too religious with it. Like, you know what? That's your shtick, dog. But don't try to fucking shove your Christian bullshit in your fans' faces because you kept it twisted. You know what I'm saying? Originally. And now it's like you found Jesus, and it's like, whatever, dude.
There you have it. Yeah. I could picture maybe if there was a bigger community out there for Juggalos, you being one of them.
Juggalos, as long as they ain't no fucking sick fuck, you'd feel me.
No, that's...
I grew up listening to both Eminem and ICP, and this is why I think the whole Juggalo, Juggalette, Eminem shit's fucking stupid.
No.
It's rap. You're essentially part of the same genre, and y'all grow up in the same motherfucking goddamn motherfucking state. And it's just like, oh, well, you said this. Well, you said that. Fucking kiss my Asperger's, dude.
Amen.
Fucking fuck the drama. Fuck the mass shootings. Fuck the sickos. Fuck rape. Fuck abuse. Fuck our fucking manipulative society. Pumping our fucking children's food for full of hormones. And then overly sexualizing children on top of it. Get the fuck out of here with that shit.
Yeah. You were about to start freestyling just then. I started hearing it come in. Almost broke into a rap.
Not going away! Away from me!
Oh, man. Is that it?
On. One second.
Oh, okay.
I don't want to click on photos. Get the fuck out of here, photos.
That's right. Get that camera on.
Yeah,
Cobra's Frog. Here we go.
I got nothing.
There you go. Oh, yeah. Get the mixture just right. Dial in that balance. Dial it in. Cobra is not going anywhere. That was a solid message to the trolls. You ain't going anywhere.
No, I ain't going anywhere. It doesn't matter whether I drink or not. I own the trolls and I have a good time in life, even if I'm not smoking weed or drinking alcohol, to be honest.
Yeah, you don't have to drink alcohol or smoke weed to have fun.
No, you really don't. It's really your perspective on things, and that's the primary principle of Cobra Cult. It's the principle of the matter, and your perspective on things, you know. The fuck sickos. It's the future of Cobra Cult, so that's why I'm against it.
Can we get a really big spell tonight? I think we have some good energy right now.
What are you wanting the spell for?
Oh, let's pick a troll that you really don't like. How's that sound?
Sounds groovy.
Who's number one on the list? Is it Bite Size? Is it Boglum Chronicles?
Bite Size can fuck off.
Oh, you're not a fan, are you? You don't like him.
Fuck Bite Size. He's
there. Yeah. Let's get a spell going. Let's concentrate a little bit. We can get a slow burn. But if he's an evil person, let's craft a spell and we'll start targeting him, okay? I'll join in. I'll lend you my energy. You know the spirit bomb? I'm sending you my energy right now. Can you feel it?
Not really.
Oh, let me try a little harder. It may get to you. I'm not a wizard or a sorcerer, but I can try.
You're an autistic, Harry. I'm a lot autistic. I'm doing good one now.
Yeah, man. If we can get a spell going, let's curse him. Let's curse Bite Size. You have it in you. I know you do.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But like you said, it's very fair. If he's a bad guy, he'll get the punishment. But if he's actually a decent person, it won't be as bad.
Exactly.
There you go. So I'm going to focus a little bit. Is there an incantation or something that we can say as we get this spell ready?
Yes. Fuck by size Cobra. He's a piece of shit troll.
Is there anything that chat should say if they want to pitch in? Just like a ooh, or like a praise Cobra's magic.
I fucking feel like preaching, man.
Chat, like, give me like a ooh. Ooh.
And if Bite Size Cobra is a piece of shit, which he already is in my book, then he'll fucking face the wrath.
Maybe he'll give you the money he owes you too, huh?
No shit.
Yeah. Ooh. Oh, it's coming in. It's coming in. Yeah. Ooh. All right. It's revving up. They're sending the energy your way, Cobra. Can you sense that?
What's that?
Can you sense the energy? Chat's going crazy right now.
Are they? Yeah. I can feel a slight tingle in the force, yes.
Okay, good, good. They're pitching in. They're dedicating their energy. They're going, ooh. All right. Do you have the words ready for this spell?
Sometimes you don't need words. Just put the thought out there, you know?
Sometimes it's just a feeling. All right. Can I request that we see the camera when you cast the spell?
Yeah, let me get my drink situation settled, so I got
absolutely. Absolutely.
All right, you ready to cast the fucking spell?
Everyone, chat, you ready? Yeah, here we go. Here we go. Oh, shit. Oh, fuck. Yeah. Yeah. You guys seeing this? Are you guys seeing this? Holy shit. That guy knows real magic. Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. Oh. Cobra.
What's that?
Cobra, there was some chi flowing all over the room. Did you see it in the little camera preview thing?
I did, yes.
There Jesus.
Was, Jesus Christ is a cunt.
Sweet Lucifer, I should say.
Yes. There was Tai Chi flowing out of the tip of the wand.
Yeah.
That's what I was trying to project.
Dude, I saw it. That was unreal. There was some energy in that. You must have it out for that guy. Again,
all
everyone
spread misinformation. It's not just Bicep Cobra. If you don't have a situation, then shut your fucking mouth.
What are some of the biggest lies that they spread about you?
Fuck sickos for starters.
Yeah.
Say it because you already know.
They try to say you're creeping on kids and
fuck that nasty
dead. Yeah.
Dude,
yeah.
I think the rest of my life without sex. I fucking hate pedophiles, dude.
Dude, earlier you said you would give up your eyeballs and your balls to get rid of chymos. You are committed.
Every cobra, including King Cobra, has to end it. My dry spell. My dream house, so I could never have sex, drink, or smoke again, you know. But bashing is fucking legit. If anyone's got a problem with it, then that just makes them a fucking sicko.
You speak the truth, Cobra. Fuck sickos, fuck chymos.
Yes!
Oh, shit.
Sorry.
That blew my hair back, Cobra. That was intense.
This just came out of nowhere. Whoopsie-daisy.
Well, I'm going to be keeping my ear close to the ground on what the hell's going to happen to Bite Size, because that was a big-ass spell that you just cast.
Fuck the trolls that can all suck Satan's dick.
Yeah, they can kiss his big red ass.
Yeah, pretty much.
You don't get enough credit, Cobra. All the things that you can do, the freestyling, the spells, telling it like it is, you don't get enough credit.
It's not about the credit, man. It's about the fans.
It's about the fans. Because you love your fans. You care about them.
Exactly. I love my fans more than I love my dark powers.
Speaking of fans, I'm worried about Crystal. She has not come back in quite some time. She left that hair dye in for probably 2.5 hours, maybe.
I just got back. I'm here.
Oh, welcome back.
I still have a full head of hair. Unfortunately, it is not brown.
What have we got?
It's still green, and there's even purple in it still. I think that everybody was right when they said I should have gone with black.
Can we see?
As soon as I'm done.
Well, I must paint it black.
Cobes is definitely
he's in the zone right now.
He's. I heard him sing it with
Rolling Stones, baby.
Yeah. Nice. He's been casting spells. He unleashed
that burp. I just heard that. That demon come out.
The demon came out hard a second ago. There it is.
That burp had to be 5 seconds long. That was insane. I didn't even know that was possible.
It was impressive.
Cobes, I have a question for you, because, and this kind of has to go, this goes along with the gender things and the double standard or whatever. I would like to talk to you about, how do you feel about girls pooting in front of you, just ripping them?
I'm cool with it.
Really?
I think farts are funny.
So do I. I think farts are all fucking
for gender equality, and I realize that women, much like men, have to face double standards and gender-based bullshit. And the gender-based bullshit that women have to face is that
we're not allowed to fart.
Exactly. You're not very ladylike.
Fart. But we have to endure. We have to endure you guys just ripping them left and right.
Exactly my point.
And that's bullshit.
It is. That's why I get so pissed off
about fucking gender-based bullshit.
I agree. I cannot agree with you more. You guys don't have an In-N-Out out there where you're at in Wyoming, do you?
We might. Why?
I don't think you do. I don't know if you do or not, though, because that's like the best fucking burger you will have ever had in your entire life. That's why.
I'm aware of the fact that I'm getting trolled this way.
No, Cobra, it was the way you said it. She's talking about In-N-Out Burger.
Have you? Yeah, I'm not trolling you.
But you were really suspicious of her just then.
You got suspicious when you're the King Cobra, baby.
Yeah, man. No, it's just the delivery. Sometimes you say things and it makes me laugh, dude. That's it.
Cobra, I need magic right now, like for Rizzle.
If there's any words of encouragement.
You know, apparently, babe. You just gotta believe it.
Oh, I know.
That's right.
It'll happen.
And she needs to hear it, Cobra.
Any more encouragement you can offer, Cobra? I think it would mean a lot right now for Crystal.
Can you just say live for me right here? I'm gonna come on camera now.
There she is. Here.
It's literally just not, it's the same exact as it was before, green and swamp.
Anyway. I don't see any green.
What are you talking about, Cobra? Look at this.
Okay, I see a little bit of green, but it's not.
Well,
it doesn't look bad.
It doesn't look as green as it did, right?
Talk to like that, because it doesn't look that bad, to be honest.
Okay. And you would tell me if it did, right?
Yeah, so would.
Good.
Tells it like it is.
So, but your outgoing voicemail to me is... I've actually used that as like motivation in the morning to get up and to face my day. If you could just go on camera quick and just say, I'm too busy. What do you say? I'm too busy kicking ass at life.
Yes.
That would literally just make my night.
Yeah, I'm too busy kicking ass at life. Fuck the trolls. And check out Crystal's videos. Yeah.
What do you say, Cobra? You want to get played out?
Yeah, I'm down.
All right. Let me get it ready. I'm going to cue it up. Bear with me. If you have any parting words, I was going to say it's been great. It's been a lot of fun.
Yeah, shout out to Crystal Roberts. Fuck the trolls.
Fuck the haters.
Fuck the haters. Check out Satan's Bell. Yes. Thank you.